Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Shoei here again with yet another video for you guys. But this time we are doing a makeup review tutorial. I'm just giving you guys the tea on this company and the tea on the shipment and everything. It's gonna be really, really fun. Okay, so as you guys can see, I already have my eyebrows done and stuff ready for the tutorial. And it's not gonna be a full face tutorial. I'm just doing one eye for you guys, and then I'm gonna do the other eye off camera because then the video is gonna be too long. So I'm actually doing an unboxing with you guys. So here is my package. So this palette, I did order it. Today is Wednesday. I ordered it on Monday night. Mind you, I ordered this like around 10 o'clock at night and I got it on Wednesday. So I got it pretty fast. I am located in Texas. See, the facility is located in New Orleans, so I am gonna get it faster than if you do live up north. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this package with you guys. So this is the box right here, guys. This is the box that it comes in, and it says crayon case. It comes in a black box, and it comes with this just in case if it says report. It says report to the office. If I have a problem with my shipment, I just send this card to them just to return the item if I have any issues with it, but that is super duper cute. This palette goes for $30, but I actually paid $36.95 because it was $6.95 for shipment. So shipment is a little pricey, and I feel like the shipment is pricey depending on where you are located. Let's actually take this out of here. Let me see if there's anything additional. There's this little thank you card. So here she is in bubble wrap, and there is some tissue paper that says the brand's name, really cute. This is the box. The box is really big. It's actually as big as I thought it would be. And taking her out, she is in bubble wrap. Here she is, guys. Here she is. We're about to look at these colors real quick. Ooh, thank God, guys. She is not broken at all. So this is it right here. Look at how freaking beautiful this is. Oh my God. All right. So we're gonna start with color swatching. And the color pans are so big. They're like about this big. Look at that. Oh my God. And this mirror on this palette is everything. Amazing. I'm already. I'm gonna start with the color blue, which is literally blue. This is it right there. So it brings 9 iridescent colors and 9 matte colors. So you guys can see. Green. That red is super pigmented. I don't have any red eyeshadows, so I'm happy that that's really pigmented. Really want to try, which is gonna be yellow, and it looks like it's about to be super pigmented. That's yellow. So yellow is not really showing up like on the camera, but in person it's really pigmented for it being yellow. That's black. I'm gonna do all the color swatches off camera, and then I'm gonna show you guys when I'm done. So I was eating off camera and color swatching at the same time because I'm starving, guys. But here are all the colors, pretty much. One of the colors didn't show up on my skin because it matches like my skin tone, and I believe, where did I place that color? It's somewhere over here, but it was the tan color. So that's like the only color that is not pretty much showing up, but I don't remember what. I think I could stop that yellow. So this one is brown, this one is orange, this one's violet. After violet, this one is supposed to be the blue one, but you can't really see it, so let me just, so that's baby blue, right? So that one is baby blue. Right here at the corner we have the lime green one, which I think it's really amazingly pigmented. This is deep plum. This one right here is the gold. This one is silver. This one is white. This one is magenta, I believe. Yeah, that's magenta. And then this one right here is violet. It's either violet or purple. And this one right here is the pink one. So those are the color swatches. I absolutely, I'm already excited. We're gonna go ahead and get started with this tutorial. The primer that I'm gonna be using is going to be the NYX Eye Base, and this is the skin tone one. I just really like this one for bright colors, so I'm gonna be using this one. And so I'm gonna go ahead, let me put my hair back because it's about to get
right. Guys, so I'm gonna go through a whole voiceover through this whole tutorial. So basically I'm just packing on the primer on my eyes, and I'm blending it out with a beauty blender because I want it to lay very smooth. So then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set it with the Dolce & Gabbana foundation powder with the brush, and I'm gonna start with the tan color on the palette, and I'm putting that on my crease. I noticed that it, you know, it kind of skips a little bit, so it, that kind of had me a little, you know, a little upset, but you know, I tried to blend it out as much as possible, and at the end it did blend out a little bit better. And then I'm gonna go over it with the yellow, which the yellow was very, very pigmented, by the way. I'm very, very happy that it came out as pigmented as it did. I will be trying that one on my lids in the future because I feel like it would be such a beautiful color on the lids. And yeah, I'm just blending that out. And then I'm gonna go ahead with the tan again, but I'm gonna go into my inner crease with a smaller brush. It was a little hard, I'm gonna tell you guys, to kind of blend it out, but I went back in with the other brush that I was using, the larger brush with the yellow, to kind of smooth it out. And then I'm gonna go in with the color brown, and I'm gonna go into my inner crease again, but now I'm deepening my crease a little bit more. And after that, I'm gonna go ahead and just blend that out with the first brush that I used that had the yellow on it, to kind of smooth everything out, because I felt like some of these colors, they were sticking way too much to my primer. It could have been the way I was setting them, but I really, really had to go in multiple times to kind of blend it out, because the way it was sitting kind of funny. So now I'm gonna cut my crease with the same primer, and make sure that when you are cutting your crease, you want to pack on the product, because you want to make sure that the eyeshadow that you're putting on your eyelids is as opaque as possible, especially if you're going to use a color like what I'm going to use. Mind you, this look is not planned, so this is me freestyling. So I'm going to go ahead and use that lime, that beautiful lime color on my lids, and I'm just going to pack that on my lids. I wanted to use as much colors as possible, you know, from the palette, but unfortunately, like, I just used a couple. But this is the lime green, and I was really shocked at how pigmented this green was. This green was so beautiful on my lids, and in person, it was a lot more pigmented. So now I'm gonna go in with the pink. And guys, this pink is crazy. Like, the pink had me shook. Like, I can't wait to use this pink in other looks, because this is probably the most pigmented pink I have ever encountered. Like, as soon as I put it on, and I didn't even have that much on my brush, it was amazing. So I'm gonna go in with the plum on my lash line. I actually did switch up the colors off camera, and I did end up using some blues. So when you see the finished look, it's gonna look a little different. And I'm gonna use my e.l.f. eyeliner in jet black, just to kind of line my eyes and to prep to put some lashes on. These lashes that I'm using, they're from Salon Perfect, and I got them at Walmart. Got this 5-pack for like $9, and I'm just using my dual glue to put it on, pretty much.
So now I'm just gonna add some mascara to kind of marry the lashes together, so that, you know, it looks a little bit more intense and it looks more natural as well with the lashes. And this is pretty much the finished eye look, guys. And this is the finished full face look. I will be listing all the products that I use on the entire face on my description box, so make sure that you guys check that out as well. First of all, box of crayons, Box of Crayons. I definitely love this palette. I am so in love with it. There are a few things that I want to say before, you know, before I keep praising it. So, first of all, throughout my tutorial, you guys seen, you know, the colors that I used. I really, like, at first I was about to use neutral colors, and then I stopped myself and I told myself, Joanna, no, because I know your audience probably wants to see these bright colors in the palette. So I didn't use all of them, guys, but I will be bringing more tutorials where I'll be using more of the colors. But I did use the lime green, the pink, the yellow. I believe I used tan, and I used the baby blue and the blue on my on the bottom of my lash line. And I did use the black in my waterline. I will be also listing the rest of the products that I used on my face, because of course I didn't give you guys a full face tutorial. I'll be bringing more full face tutorials, and of course I will be featuring this baby again. A few thoughts. So first of all, I did love her, but I did notice a few things. So with the matte shades, especially, you know, with the lime green, which lime green came out gorgeous, although I did experience a little bit of chalkiness, just a little bit, and it could have been how I set my primer, which you guys seen I used my NYX primer, but then again, I don't feel like it was my primer because I used the same technique with all my other eyeshadow looks. So I kind of was experiencing that just a little bit, but maybe next time I'll use a different primer or I'll just set it differently. I did also experience just a little bit of skipping with the tan color on my crease. So I don't know if you guys noticed that while I was kind of blending it out, but I was having a little bit of difficulty with that because I felt like it was kind of like skipping a little bit. But again, it could have been the way that I set my primer. Other than that, the colors were very pigmented. The yellow was extremely pigmented. For it just being on my crease, it was very, very pigmented. I would love to try it on my lids, so maybe my next look tutorial or one of my next looks on Instagram will be with that yellow, because this lime green is definitely popping. This pink, y'all see my reaction when I put the pink on. The pink was so pigmented that it shocked the shit out of me. Like, I was like, what the, like, I couldn't believe it. So yeah, it had me very shocked. Okay, but that's a good thing, because, you know, at least, you know, it was really nice and pigmented, and it was really nice. So it was really pigmented. I love that. Yeah, other than that, I felt like it was a really smooth. I did my eyes pretty quick. It didn't take me that long, to be honest with you. I love the palette. There isn't really much I can say that's bad about it. I would just say just really take care of it, because I can tell, like, these eyeshadows are really, really smooth and soft. And I feel like if you drop this, it is over. Like, it is over. So make sure that you do take care of it. I think I'm gonna go ahead and put her back in her box with the bubble wrap and everything. I'm not even playing. Y'all think I'm playing right now, probably, but I'm gonna go ahead and do that, because I just got her, and honestly, she was a gift. My boyfriend got her for me, so I'm gonna make sure that I really, really take care of it. Just a few things before I go. The back of the box just tells you the website. I know I didn't go over that. And then it tells you the ingredients. It tells you the ingredients, and it is cruelty free. So just in case if you guys wanted to know, it is cruelty free, and it does have a 12 month lifespan. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you guys already tried this palette. Let me know if you guys want to buy this palette. Let me know, like, you know, if you plan on buying it. Let me know if there's any looks that you guys want me to see. What would you have wanted me to have done? You know, if there was anything that you didn't like, that's fine. You guys can let me know in the comments below. Make sure that you guys check out. Make sure that you check them out. The crayon case. Make sure that you guys check out the crayon case on their Instagram. And make sure that you get your hands on this, especially if you're a makeup artist, because this would be a definitely great palette to have in your kit. And make sure that you guys also check me out on Instagram at Peralta Knows Best if you guys have not done so. Make sure that you also hit that subscribe button. What are you waiting for? And make sure that you also hit that like button if you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you guys soon. Bye.